Mr. President, our second work was about our new experience on using anti-TNF alpha agents in the same Department of Internal Medicine. The place of tumor necrosis factor alpha in the physiopathology of inflammatory and autoimmune disease has been well established. TNF alpha blockade has become a wide field of therapeutical research. Several biological agents specifically directed against TNF alpha have been developed and are now available. We have two specific agents, anti-TNF alpha monoclonal antibodies and TNF alpha soluble receptors. It has a great efficacy, but in our country, we have a challenging problem with the risk of developing tuberculosis. The aim of this study is to describe the experience of using TNF alpha blockers in the internal medicine department in University Hospital of Casablanca in a developing country like Morocco. We collected patients' data using the biological agent register. This register was created 1 year ago in the internal medicine department. We included all patients from December 2015 to October 2016 who were receiving anti-TNF agents regardless of their underlying diseases. We reported their demographic features, their underlying diseases, and numbered complications that they have experienced under anti-TNF agents. Our results, we have included 32 patients with a mean age about 32 years old, with a six ratio 0.68. A mean duration of the treatment was about 1 year a half. A remission was obtained in 70% of the cases. The anti-TNF agent that we have used in this study, it was about infliximab in 23 cases, etanercept in 5 cases. It's a monoclonal antibody, adalimumab in 4 cases. We had as a systemic disease ankylosing spondylitis in 40 cases. Rheumatoid arthritis in 9 cases, Behçet's disease in 5 cases with ocular involvement, in 1 case with the neurological involvement, a severe sarcoidosis with multi-organ involvement in 1 case, ulcerative colitis associated to a severe rheumatoid arthritis in 1 case, and psoriatic arthritis in 1 case. We have to know that in our study, about 50% of the patients were also under immunosuppressive therapy, like cyclophosphamide in 6 cases and methotrexate in 10 cases. No one had diabetes. Corticosteroids was also used in 56%. Of patients. The mean duration of the disease before anti-TNF treatment was about 4 years. No history of cancer or chronic infection was noted in the history of the patient. The tuberculin skin test was negative in 100% of the patient. We have noted some complications. 2 neoplastic complications with infliximab. It was a gastric cancer and vulvar cancer in 2 patients. An infection complication in 1 case. It was also with the infliximab. It was a miliary tuberculosis. And a novel complication. It was about paresthesia and sexual impotence with etanercept. No, with the adalimumab, we didn't notice any complication. Some discrete allergic signs were also found in some patients. So just to show you the importance of TNF alpha in this autoimmune and inflammatory disease, the TNF alpha has a role as a pro-inflammatory cytokine. It has a role as a chemokine. It has some specific role in osteoclast activation in chondrocyte activation, like in rheumatoid arthritis. Just to show you some types of anti-TNF agents. Okay. Anti-TNF biologic agents were a revolutionary treatment and had improved the prognosis of many chronic and severe diseases. The major complication was infections and malignancy, especially the cutaneous cancers. In a meta-analysis, it was especially the opportunistic infection that was relevant. It was a small sample because it's just on 1 year of follow-up. It was a retrospective and heterogeneous study. It was the minds of this study. Neoplastic and infectious complications, especially tuberculosis, are the main problems with anti-TNF agents use. A novel side effect was described with etanercept. It need to be confirmed. Overall, the results were very satisfactory, and remissions was obtained in nearly 87% of the cases. To conclude, it's the challenging problems when using these agents, especially infection and malignancy. These drugs are more limited to patients with active inflammatory disease, despite more conventional treatments. And now monitoring is needed to detect any serious side effects. And thank you.